I have to say this past week has been pretty eye-opening. I, along with every Arkansan, have watched as the events unfolding in Israel, we have watched that in horror and sadness. The details are almost too terrible to describe, especially for someone like me who has had the privilege of visiting the Holy Land and building lifelong friendships with a number of Israelis. But one thing is clear, America's enemies are on the march. They are cunning, they are brutal, and they will stop at nothing to harm America and our allies. We know who our enemies are, not just Hamas and Hezbollah, but a regime in Iran that chants death to America, an authoritarian Russia, and a Chinese Communist Party whose stated goal is to defeat the United States at every turn. Yet for too long, in the name of tolerance, we've let these dangerous governments infiltrate our country. Arkansas will tolerate them no longer. Today, we are becoming the first state in the country to take an action like the one that we are announcing right now. At the beginning of my term, my administration worked with our partners in the legislature to get hostile foreign entities out of Arkansas. I was proud to sign Act 636, sponsored by Senator Johnson and Representative Vaught, banning foreign parties from 9 enemy countries from owning agricultural land in Arkansas. And today, we are acting on that law. I'm announcing that Syngenta, a Chinese state-owned agrochemical company, must give up its land holdings in Arkansas. Syngenta owns 160 acres in northeast Arkansas, which it uses primarily for seed research. The company that owns Syngenta, Kim China, is also on the Department of Defense's list of Chinese military companies posing a clear threat to our state. Seeds are technology. Chinese state-owned corporations filter that technology back to their homeland, stealing American research and telling our enemies how to target American farms. That is a clear threat to our national security and to our great farmers, especially since the Chinese government enacted a law in 2017 requiring Chinese citizens abroad to collaborate with their country's security officials on intelligence work with no questions asked. This isn't about where you're from. We welcome Chinese Americans, Russian Americans, and anyone else who's given up foreign oppression for American freedom. This is about where your loyalties lie. We simply cannot trust those who pledge allegiance to a hostile foreign power. That's why I signed Act 525, sponsored by Representative McKenzie and Senator Boyd, to ban Chinese and Russian-made drones. And it's why I signed Act 758, sponsored by Representative McElinden and Senator Stubblefield, banning public contracts with the CCP. We will make sure that every company operating in Arkansas is a friend to Arkansas and good to hardworking Arkansans. Secretary Ward has already notified Syngenta about this decision. If they refuse to sell, our Attorney General can move forward with legal proceedings and force them to get out of our state. Arkansas will always protect our farmers and our national security interest. I want to thank our legislature for passing this common sense measure, and I want to thank the Department of Agriculture for working so hard on this issue. I will now turn it over to Attorney General Griffin to address his team's next steps. Thank you all.
Thank y'all. I want to provide a little context here. I could tell you that the idea that the Chinese government would care about non-military assets is exactly what they've demonstrated over the last few decades. In fact, we had congressional hearings in the late 90s in Washington on dual-use technologies, civilian related technologies that the Chinese were obtaining from the United States. There is nothing that's off limits for them if they think that it will strengthen them strategically, whether it be related to engineering or the ability to feed their people, which is a challenge for them. We've had some instances and some federal prosecutions in this state that relate to seed technology. And so For those of you who think that this is some sort of outlier, you're wrong. I've been in the military for almost 30 years, and I can tell you one of the consistent themes of the last decade at least has been warnings about the communist Chinese, what they will do and what they are doing. So this is smart and this is strategic. So let me tell you what my role here today is. I've written a letter, which I'll be sending today, to Northrop King, Seed, and Syngenta, informing them that they have to divest themselves of the land that they have in Craighead County. And they have 2 years, as of about a month ago, a little over a month ago, to do that. If they don't do that, then we can take legal action. We have no reason to believe that they won't do that. Also, back in 2021, the legislature, with very, very forward-looking, I will say, for the legislature to pass a law that requires these companies owned by foreign entities to file and disclose. And in this particular case, the disclosure, the ownership of this land could have been filed was June of last year. It was late. And so under that law, also I appreciate this, the AG can fine a civil penalty, can fine the company a civil penalty up to 25% maximum, doesn't have to be 25%, but up to 25% of the value of the property. The property in this case is $1.12 million, according to Syngenta's own federal filing. And so I am imposing the maximum fine of $280,000 on the company, and I am informing them of that in the letter as well. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. Wes Ward from the Arkansas Department of Agriculture, and the governor and the attorney general have covered pretty thoroughly what's happening today. And so I just want to just take a quick moment to echo that and just the importance of Arkansas agriculture, our state's largest industry, and the connection to our national security. So certainly every event that we've had with the governor, with Governor Sanders on a broad range of agricultural topics, she always starts at the beginning of every time that she has had an ag event, the connection between agriculture and our national security. So it is top of mind, obviously, for her, for us at the Department of Agriculture. So we certainly appreciate your leadership, Governor, the Attorney General, and to the members of the state legislature for your partnership and this important topic. So we'll just echo again the importance of agriculture here in the state of Arkansas, the connection to our national security. The case is pretty clear. We've done a thorough review, and we know that there are questions about foreign ownership of agricultural land throughout the United States. We're working actively to make sure that those questions are answered and that we continue to protect our state's largest industry as well as our security, both in Arkansas and across the country. And today, with the governor's help, we're sending a pretty strong message of how important that is and that what will be prohibited in the state of Arkansas. So thank you.
Well, that will open up, take a couple questions.
This is probably more for General Griffin and for the Secretary of War. I guess, have you all identified other, at least agricultural land, that would face similar action? And kind of for make sure I understand the timeline of this, if they don't comply, something would be filed in court in 2 years?
And they have 2 years to divest themselves. I'm not going to talk about anything else that we know that we're not ready to make public. I think they have 30 days to pay the fine. Well, we're looking at all of our options. We're looking at all of our options. We're not going to go to. To the extent actors are out of the country, it's hard to physically get access to them. But to the extent they have assets in the state, then we can take legal proceedings against that. So we will. I have full confidence that they're going to divest themselves of the property and they're going to pay the fine.
So I was wondering how you determine whether something is owned by the Chinese government versus someone who's just a foreign national, and also like the complexity of ownership, given that there may be multiple parties. So I'm just kind of wondering how you determine whether something is in violation.
It takes a lot of research. In this particular case, it's in their own filings. Yeah. They say, hey, we own it.
Also, they give you a look at the parent company. They're very public about the partnership that they have. And so it's a very clear sense in this particular case.
Are there any other state actors, foreign countries that own land in Arkansas that you have concerns about?
We, like the Attorney General said, when we're ready to make public any other areas and people we're watching, but certainly we're always looking and we'll continue to monitor anything that we deem that could be a threat to our state's agriculture industry as well as our national security.
Yeah, I would say, I would say one more thing as it relates to China in particular. Because of the nature of China's government structure, SOEs, as they're called, state-owned enterprises, are a way of doing business. And so the idea that there's all these prosperous, large and growing Chinese companies that don't have ties to the Chinese government, direct ties, that's just not the case. Now, there are varying degrees of ties, but in this case, these are Chinese government owned.
I've got a couple unrelated questions.
Of course, I'm sure. No surprise by anybody here.
And both of them have to do with the lector and the public records regarding it. You said before on the lector that was purchased that it had features that explained the cost of it. Can you specify that or elaborate more on what those features are? And the second question I had was on the to-be reimbursed note that was put on the original invoice by Governor Stafford. Who authorized Stafford to put that on there? Did you authorize that?
It went through standard protocol for our office on any purchase through the office manager and the team that was requesting the purchase to be made. In terms on specific features, the height of the podium is specific. I don't know if you've noticed, but women are traditionally a little bit shorter than most of our male counterparts. And so that makes a little bit of a difference, but it also incorporates sound components that make it easier to plug in for multiple media outlets at one time to get the best sound quality, I guess, possible for relaying back to TV and purposes of that nature, and a number of other things that I'll let come through in the audit process.
Is there a reason why you're not using it today?
Yeah, because I figure if I do, then you would talk about nothing else instead of the important actions that we're actually taking today, which unfortunately is not surprising that while we are focused on things that actually impact our state and impact Arkansans, the media wants to spend all of their time focused on things that frankly don't. Any other questions? Thank you guys, we appreciate it.